لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Thank you very much for asking me to come and speak to you. And may Allah bless you for being very patient and letting me to be amongst you today. I'm very happy to be in Nigeria, as my brother said before. It's my first time and not my last time, inshallah. Let me start my interaction with you with something which I was writing when I was sitting down. I am the product of three women. Three women. The first one was Khadija, who was the supporter of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam financially, morally, and socially, and who laid down the foundation of social and humanitarian work. When Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came home one day after Hazrat Jibreel revealed the Quran on him, he was so shaken, and was telling him, the three. What she told him, what she said, Wallahi, inna Allah lan yukhzika abad. With the name of Allah, Allah will never let you down. Why? Because you connect yourself with your family. That's the rahm. Because you help the needy. Because you support the weak. And before you empower the weak as well. Khadija radiallahu anha was laying down the foundation of the social work in any community and any society before any university on earth can do that. You understand the role of women in Islam? Khadija is one of them. Khadija is one of the icons who started this role. And for that, nobody can come and teach us and tell us your woman is not empowered. We teach humanity what is the role of woman is about. This was the first woman which produced me. The second woman was my mother. May Allah bless her. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept her in heaven. She told me two things. Don't keep looking up at other rich people because you'll have a headache and neck ache. My son, keep looking down to be happy of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided you with. Then she told me what? She told me mix with the poor to be contented with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. But don't keep mixing with the rich. You'll be frustrated because they will not have what they have. This is the second woman in my life. The role of woman in Islam in my life. The third woman is my wife. You know her? You heard about her. My wife, who stood like a rock behind me. All this what be mentioned by brother Dr. Mukhtari is not my product. It is support and the help and the atmosphere that she made at home. I have 5 children, alhamdulillah. All of them are qualified from universities, 3 girls and 2 boys, 2 men. But she is the one who is absent today, but she is present in action in my heart. Here we conclude, a man, a leader, a theologian, a scholar, is a product of his mother, of his sister, of his aunt, and the woman in Islam is the cornerstone of building the society, building community, and building civilization. This is my first interaction in the introduction. The second point which I want to talk about is humanitarian work is a soft power, can go anywhere where other economic, political cannot reach, military or whatever they call it, cannot reach. So consider humanitarian work as a strong, dynamic, soft power that can reach the unreachable. That can reach the unreachable. Okay? Humanitarian work is a message. It's not a job. If somebody come and argue with a salary with you, then I thank you. We don't want you to help to work for us. It's a message that each worker is a humanitarian work should be delivering it to himself, to his family, to his community, to society, and to humanity. Humanitarian work is a mission, lifelong mission. Lifelong mission, like the prophetical message and mission of the Prophet and all other Prophets. Humanitarian work is an ability to build society, ability, it's initiative to build community as well. Humanitarian work is empowerment of the marginalized, poor, weak, and women, and children, and men, and others in this fight. It's empowerment, 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 empowerment. Humanitarian work is a partnership. Nobody can claim that they can do it alone nowadays. Partnership in humanitarian work is the kalima for Islam. Can we become a Muslim if we don't say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah? No, we can't. Partnership now in humanitarian work is like kalima in Islam. Any organization, no matter who is the chairman, no matter who are the board members, no matter how much they have, cannot do it alone. They have to come down, fight their ego, and work with other people. And consider that the local community is the most important community that you can work for, so they can become partners with us. Humanitarian work is trust. The donor trusts us. The government trusts us. The recipient trusts us. The poor people trust us. The widows trust us. The orphans trust us. The sick people trust us. The displaced people trust us. The refugees trust us. It's a trust. If we want this trust, we have to change our life into the mission and the message that we have to stand for and labor for such people. Humanitarian work is a respect, not because I work with the poor people, the uneducated, the ignorant, the sick, the weak. I don't respect them. They might have more values than what I have. They might have a closer relationship with Allah than what I have. That's why we have to respect everybody and anybody. Respect women, respect children, respect our culture, respect our other faith and the other ideology as well. Because we are living in our society, but we are not the society. We are not the country, we are not the nation. We are a part of the nation, the country, the society, and the community. Respect. Humanitarian work is building the capacity of individuals. We have to train them. The young people at the back, I love you all. Are you with me? Hey, hey, hey! I love you. I'm very happy to see young people here, because this is my dream. The second dream is to see the woman here. May Allah bless you, inshallah, my mother, not my mother, my sister, not mother. Huh? They are too young to be my mother. Thank you, leaders. building the capacity of everyone in the society, not leaving anyone behind, no matter who is this one, whether it's from my country, my society, my clan, my religion, or from somewhere else. Building society to increase the ability of the individual to increase his or her productivity. Humanitarian work is building leadership. You know, brothers in the front, the wise in the front, leadership there at the back. Leadership at the back with the young people. Bring the young leadership to the front. Make them to be amongst you while you are in position, so they can take the knowledge and the experience from each and every one of us. Humanitarian work is to protect our country. You know why I help protect our country from humanitarian work? Because we know the weakness in our country. We know the vulnerable area in our country. And we can strengthen the weakness, or we can report it to the government so they can strengthen the weakness. So we protect our countries from outside and from inside. From inside, by building strong bond between different sides and strengthening the social infrastructure of the country. From outside, we're protecting the country from the wrong ideology and the bad people who come to divide my community and my country. Humanitarian work is to stand for climate change in Nigeria, or in Cameroon, or in Congo, or in Angola, or in Amazon. Why should we stand to stop the fire in Amazon, or Angola, or Congo? But this humanity, we have to stand for humanity to fight the fire and to fight the climate change which is affecting our life, as Dr. Mukhtari was talking about it earlier on. Humanitarian work is empowering our society, making our society become stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger. Know the value of the work that we are doing it traditionally, so we can develop it, so we can develop it, so we can develop it. The history of humanitarian work is as old as Adam, and even before Adam, because even the animals, the birds, the insects, are doing humanitarian work amongst themselves in the society. And hum illa umamun amthalukum. All those animals and birds and insects are like umam, like the umam of the human being. You remember the ant which was talking about Sulaiman when he was coming by his army. Get on, get into your dwellings. Otherwise, Sulaiman and his army will destroy you. You know the hoopoe. The hoodhood of Sulaiman as well. When he told him, he took him in Saba and Binaba and Yaqeen, I kept you from Saba, Sheba, the queen of Sheba, with the great news. The news was, it was at that time that they were not worshipping Allah. That they were not worshipping. This is a hope of it. Every being is a community, is a society, is an ummah. To conclude the introduction, Brother Mukhtari, planting a tree is planting a life. Cutting a tree is cutting a life. And you can imagine now how many millions of trees have been cut in Nigeria, from 40% to 5%. Maybe from 100 to 100 or 301 billion trees to become few million trees. This is how we are destroying our planet. This is how we are destroying the future of our children and the generation to come. This is how we are destroying our economy, our social bond, our social fabric, because we cut the tree without understanding the value of the tree for me, the value of the tree for the animal, for the birds, for the climate, for every being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. Now we can start talking. No, bring the first one, and you stop me because I don't want to carry on talking, I want them to ask questions. First one. No, second one. This say goes back to what Dr. Mukhtari was saying and what our chairman was saying here. The only thing necessary for evil to thrive is for good men like you. For good men like you, is to do nothing. That's why this was the mission of the Prophet ﷺ, was revealed for him and for other prophets to stop the evil from spreading and do the good thing actually for the community as a whole. Our core message as well, Surah Al-Ma'un. Surah Al-Ma'un is a very dynamic surah, extremely dynamic, and the cornerstone of the humanitarian world. Those who deny the day of judgment are those who treat the orphans badly or do not advocate for the need of the need. The people who deny the day of judgment are such people who treat orphans badly and do not advocate for the needs of the needy, or the needs of the hungry, or the needs of the homeless. Advocacy, brothers and sisters, especially young men, young women, was not new to Islam. Now they come and teach us advocacy. Why don't you do advocacy? Advocacy is here. Advocacy is here. But we don't understand the value of the treasure of Islam, and the value of the treasure of Quran, and the value of the treasury of the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who left humanity in a safe place because of his teaching. Now we are destroying humanity because we are not following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We talk about coexistence. The ayah, Ya ayyuhan nas. إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى. Allah said ناس. Did not say مؤمنين. Did not say مسلمين. Did not say Arab. Did not say Africa. He said, oh mankind, who have created you from male and female. And who made you tribes. Different tribes. Different nation. Different culture. Different language. Different ethnicity. To know one another. And to exist with one another. And the best amongst us is the one who is benefiting others. And Allah in this ayah never said that is this for the Muslims only or for humanity. This is the foundation of coexistence and acquaintance. We have all the foundation for humanity. But why we are not doing it? Why we are not building humanity on the principles of the teaching of the teacher of humanity? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. في كل كبد رتب صدقة. I'm going to take off my jacket because I'm getting hot for the fight. I'm going to fight now. في كل كبد رتب صدقة. In every living soul, there is charity. You know, there was a prostitute from the children of Israelites. And she was passing by a panting dog. He was very thirsty. And she took her shoes and she went to the well to bring some water for the dog to help him. Allah ghafara laha. Allah has forgiven her for just getting this small water to the dog. And she was not a Muslim at that time. I think she was a prostitute from Bani Israel. Valuing the other. We never disrespect anyone. Valuing others, responsibility towards humanity. And the third one, believe in the destiny. Then after that, there are three formula in this process, valuing others. Valuing others. There's religious formula, there's values and principles formula, and there's partnership formula. Next. Religious formula. Why should I divide community on the four S? Salafi, Shi'i, Sunni, and Sufi. Why? 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 Our community contain every and each one of them. We have to learn to work together. We have to learn to live together. Okay? This is on the religious form. This is on the value form. I have my tree. You are trying to plant a dead tree this morning in the College of Technology. And my dead tree is trust, respect, engage, empower. Trust the community. Engage with the community. Empower the community and respect the community. We cannot build the community unless and until we respect them. Three, trust, respect, engage, empower. The third formula is partnership. You have to bear with me on this one. Partnership between the international community and the local community. I bought this formula more than 11 years ago. I called it FAD KISS formula. FAD KISS formula. FAD. This is the role of international community, and you have to be very adamant on that. Very adamant. International organization coming here, yes, this is your role. F, fundraise. A, advocate. T, to train us. We want from you to advocate, fundraise, and train. That's it. That's it. So you bring me the fat. Clear? Yes, young men at the back. Hey, hey, hey. Yeah, you are sleeping, huh? Fundraise, advocate, and train. Okay, this is them. If I come as an international organization, I have to tell them, this is your duty in my country. Second one, this is my duty as a local community. KISS, knowledge base, innovation, innovative, sustainable solution. I am the one who have the know-how to find a sustainable, innovative solution on the knowledge that I have. So you give me the fat, I give you the KISS. What is that? See, it means partnership between both of us. The international community has to provide us with the fact, then we can provide them with innovative, sustainable solution. Solution is local. Solution is local. Solution is not coming from London, or Paris, or Rome, or New York, or Riyadh, or Kuwait, or others. Solution coming from the local community. Localization, localization, localization. Characteristic of people like you, immigrant worker. We have to believe in our community. We have to have a message to deliver, mission to accomplish, product to provide, personal trait, modesty, honesty, hardworking, and so on, so on, so on, so on. Clear? Not anyone can stand on the platform and declare that he or she is the champion of the community unless he or she bend their back to the community. Listen to the community. Be with the community when the community needs them. Come forward to stand up when the community is in danger. Endanger their life and take the risk for the community as well. It's very complicated, I will skip it. But if you want to challenge the challenge of building partnership goes from the first, I get into these steps very quickly, First of all, we have to verify the information we have. إن جاءكم فاسقهم بنبأ فتبينوا قبل أن تصيبوا قوم بجهلة. For any information you have to verify first, then read and analyze, then create knowledge, then communicate, then network, then empower, trust, then you can build partnership. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 steps before you build partnership. Why should I build partnership with you without knowing you? We did this example with CAFOD, Catholic Aid for Overseas Development, in UK Catholic. And they met with me in a place called Gateshead near Newcastle. And I was there for a reason, and they were there for a reason. And one of them, the CEO, said that would love to work with Islamic Relief. Would love to be seen, but we are working together. I said, okay, fine. It took us 2 years to build partnership between two organizations. 2 years, 2 years, 2 years. Challenging a building society. This is very important. Training our staff, our volunteers, capacity building, environmental projects. You see, we're talking about environmental projects. This paper has been written more than 17 years ago. But environmental project was on the table at that time. No, they bring it back. Environmental project, you see, helping the ethnic minorities and the other related type of social work is more difficult. If we divide our work into humanitarian in this side and social in this side, you know what's the difference between humanitarian and social? Humanitarian, when you start doing some humanitarian work and helping people. Social, when you start to fight the climate, to empower people, to talk for advocacy, to make human rights, all these sort of things. Building social movement is more difficult than building a humanitarian movement. Difficulties in the society, how can we meet the challenges? Some of the challenges is the tribal leaders. The gatekeepers. Gatekeepers, like in every area, is somebody non-state actor holding guns in their hands. We have to deal with them. Islamophobia on the rise, counter-terrorism is a challenge. Media, lying media and policies, lack of human resources, individualism, when people think that they are going to do it alone, and competition between organizations. All these are challenges. Challenges, 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 challenges. Even why we're succeeding in different countries, like China, our first project was in the Buddhist area. In 2002, where the flood was destroying the area, and we were building with the Chinese government about 350 or 400 houses for the Buddhists, not for the Muslims. That's why there's no compulsion in our religion or no compelling anybody to come to Islam. This is what we've been doing in South Sudan. We have been invited by Sudanese People Liberation Army or movement to go and welcome us as Muslim charity to work in South Sudan. I have one. In South Sudan, okay, in Philippines as well, in what is the other one? Nepal, when the earthquake came in this area, even helping the non-Muslims in different areas, whether in Africa or in Latin America, with Muslims or with non-Muslims. Next, please. There's some examples from the history of a Prophet Yusuf, but I will skip this one. Carry on, please. Zulqarnain, you know the story of Zulqarnain? Zulqarnain? Okay, he empowered the local community. Then he transferred the technology to them to build the wall. Then he left them to be independent. He never took anything from them for any war. Carry on, please. The hookah bird and the ant, you know that, I mentioned it. Next, please. success story, Musa alayhi salam. Okay, carry on. I finished. Now I want you to grill me. You can grill, or roast, or boil, or you can do the three. I have got a very thick skin. Very thick skin. Who is the first one amongst you will grill me?
My respected elders, honorable scholars, distinguished brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. My question to you is a really a brilliant one. You talk about partnership between international and local communities, and here, the local community, we have SOZECOM, who are really trying to empower the masses, and when you talk about empowering the marginalized, this is what they have been doing. Now, people coming from the international community, what assurance are you going to give us of partnering with this SOZECOM in order to make this good partnership with the development of the masses? Thank you.
All right, thank you. First of all, we have to sort our house, you know, to put our house in order. To put our house in order. Have good governance, in my organization, in my local organization, transparency, accountability, okay? And empowering the young people inside the organization and women inside the organization, not leaving people behind, anybody behind. This is before I partner with you. If I never partner with you, I need to do this. This is number one. Number two, we have to build coalition. Now I've got the Dawah Commission.
DCCN.
That's Dawah Coordinating Council as a block. You can stand for your right. You can do it for humanitarian organization. Can do it for advocacy when we as local organizations can sit down together and put our head together to try to look at the future of our community and how can we make partnership with the international organization or UN organization. We don't know how to build a coalition or commission or council. We have to build, keep building the council. Okay. We in the UK built forum made out of 15 organizations or platform made out of 400, 300, 500 organizations. So we cannot build this brother unless we fight the ego in our heart. See? One of the conditions is to build a platform for all the membership organizations is to have the chairmanship is not a member of the organization. You should not be a chairman of the organization if you are a member of a membership organization. If we do this, we'll be able to speak the language of the international community. And who dare to say what? No, I don't need your money. You don't like the project. You should not compete from behind one another to get the money from the international organization. But you should say that this project is no good for our society, for our community. We don't want it. Go with your money and go away. They will change the policy. They will change the policy if we become the collective that can say no. That can say no. Once you say no, they will change the money. But if only one in the one organization say no and the rest take the money, so they will give the money to anybody. With all of this, I have to build, or maybe to strengthen my house, or put my house in order in the country. Plus, I have to bring all my brothers and sisters, organizations in the city together to have a platform to protect not only my organization, only, but the whole district, the whole state, the whole country. Okay? Yes, brother. Anyone else? I'm ready for five.
Somebody's raving hard there.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. ya bude da maganar mata irin gudunmuwar da mata suke bai da kuma yin yadda musulunci ya kula da mata watan abin da yake so ya ce daga farko shine idan wanda ya tallafa ma mace ya tallafa ma dan adam ya kawo mana hadisin da ke cikin sahih bukhari da babin na farko nana na aisha da take rawaito mana cewa nana khadija radiyallahu anha lokacin da annabi ya fito daga cikin kogo lokacin bai san annabci ba bai san manzanta ba yazo ya same ta yana cikin tashin hankali da ya haɗu da malaika jibril abinda ta fara gaya mai shine wallahi la yuziyaka allah abada na rike da allah ba zai taba walakanta ka ba zai taba kaskasta ka ba saboda mai tace innaka la tasilur rahim wa tahmilul kalla wa taqawi dhaifa wa tuhinu ala nawaibil haq saboda kai kana sada zumunta domin kai kana taimakon wanda baya da domin kai kana ciyar da bako abinci domin kai kana taimako ayyukan alkhairi sai ya kasance cewa ta gaya mai cewa duk wanda ke irin wannan taimako na tallafi ga ɗan adam ba zai taɓa kaskasta ba wannan kasa malamai suka ce lokacin ba ta da qur'ani ba ta da hadisi amma yau da gobe ta ɗan adam ta nuna duk mai taimako Allah zai taimaka mai don ka sai ya karfafe mu na cewa idan muka tallafi karfafa ma mata ya ba da labari reno ne da mamashi ta yi da kuma gudunmuwar da mai ɗaki shi ta bashi wajen samar da irin wannan tallafin wanda yake an taimaki mata aka tallafa musu kamar an taimaki al'umma masu yawa domin su ke ba da tarbiyya kuma su ke yano al'umma kuma su ke ba da shawara haka ya yi magana game da tallafa ma marasa ƙarfi har ya kawo suratul ma'un ayatul ladhi yukadhibu biddin fa dhalika alladhi yad'u al-yatim yace wannan surar tana nuna cewa waɗanda ba su yarda da tashin kiyama ba su ke wahal da maraye su ke su abba su taimakawa wajen ayyukan kwarai haka rashin taimako ga ayyukan kwarai sun faci wanda yake ba ta musulmi ba ya yi domin bayani akan haka abu da ya bayani na gaba ya bayani game da in kana so ka taimaki ɗan adam akwai muhimmancin shibka itace wanda shibka itace yana taimakawa wajen rage haɗari da ke zuwa na iska haɗari da ke zuwa na ruwan sama abubuwa da ke zuwa yana taimakawa wajen rage zafin da gari yake da shi wanda ke wannan taimako ne ga ɗan adam taimako ne ga dukkan abu mai rai kamar da ya kawo hadisi annabi ya ce fi kulli kabirin ghadabi sadaqa duk anta mai sanyi wato duk abu mai rai in ka taimake shi karkara da sadaka ta nan ya karfafi cewa a dinga shuka itace domin shuka itace ɗai in ka yi ka taimaki ɗan adam kuma ka taimaki dabbobi da yawa dr mutar shi makafin dr hani dr mutar abinu kano ya yi ba ma ƙungiyar zakka da wakafi a kan irin wannan shuka itacen da take yi wanda yana kare haɗurra da yawa da suke afkuwa ga al'umma haɗurran iska haɗurran ruwan sama haɗurran yawan zafin rana abu da gaba da dr hani ya yi magana ya yi magana game da muhimmancin haɗa kai tsakanin ƙungiyoyi na duniya irin waɗanda shi yake shugabanci da ƙungiyoyi da muke da su nan cikin gida kamar irin su zakka da wakafi domin samar da ci gaban taimakon al'umma wannan shi yafi burge ni wanda ni mai tambaya wani irin gudunmuwa za su bai na haɗa kai tsakanin su da ƙungiyar zakka da wakafi na tabbata kila malamin mai ɗauki kila zai mana bayani irin kafin ya tafi irin haɗin kai haɗin gwiwar da za su yi domin gudunmuwar da ya ce suna bayarwa a ƙasashe ya kasance ta mata kawo nan an san da ita don ka yi bayanin cewa idan za a haɗa kai akwai wasu abubuwa da ƙungiyoyi masu tahowa daga ƙasashen waje za su zo da shi akwai kuma tanadi da tattali da ƙungiyoyi na ciki za su yi cikin abin da ƙungiyoyi na ciki za su yi shine su san garinsu su ba da ilimi na abin da garin ya kunsa ga wa'innan ƙungiyoyin da za su tahowa kuma su ba su enabling environment su tabbata sun ba su yanayi mai kyawu wanda za su shigo wani yanayi mai kyawu ya haɗu zaman lafiya a gari ya haɗu tarbo ya haɗu da ba su duk wata gudunmuwa da suke bukata su kuma sai su kawo tallafi da ake zamanin suna da shi na kuɗi tallafi da ake zamanin suna da shi na ilimi tallafi da ake zamanin da shi suna da shi na harkar zartarwa domin a ciyar da al'umma gaba ciki abin da ya yi magana da shi ciki ya ce kada addini ya zama sanadiyyar rabuwar jama'a don mi zai kasancewa maimakon addini ya zama abin da zai haɗa jama'a su yi ayyuka na kwarai ayyukan ci gaban al'umma sai kasance kungiyanci wanda yana kungiya kaza ya lissa wasu kungiyoyi da ya rubuta a kan allo don mi kungiyanci zai kasance abin da zai hana mutane su yi ayyukan da za su ci gaba da yawa wani abu na tasowa sai a ce wannan don ɗan kungiya kaza ne wannan don ɗan kungiya kaza ne wannan don ɗan kungiya kaza ne idan ɗan kungiya kaza ya haɗa kai ɗan kungiya kaza domin ciyar da ɗan adam gaba domin ciyar da al'umma gaba to wannan ya fi kyautatuwa a cikin wannan tunani ya fito daga addini da cewa tunani ya rabuwa ya fito daga addini abu na ƙarshe da ya mai da himma a kan shi shine ba ma ƙungiyoyi ba har addinai ma ana iya hada kai da wanda ba musulmi ba domin a samar da ci gaban dan Adam. Ya kawo aya daga cikin suratul Hujurat, ya ku mutane, yace Allah ya ce ya ku mutane, bai ce ya ku mu'minai ba. Na halicce ku daga mace da namiji, in sanya ku al'ummomi da ƙabiloli a domin ku san juna. Watan ana iya taimakekeniya da kowace al'umma, har ya bada misali da cewa sun haɗa kai da Japan da Philippines da China wajen samar da ayyuka da tallafi da mutanen da tallafi da mutanen da damuwa ta sama da mutanen da bala'uka suka auka ba. Ya bada misali a irin ambaliyar ruwa da aka samu a wajen yadda na Japan da China da kuɗin tallafi da suka bai, da kasancewar su musulmi ne.
Wani shi aka kan cikin da ne ko ba san za a ce ko sai wani a ce ba. Na gode, wasu na wani kacin da kuma. Ya fi da muna muliya, Allah ya sa ka da yin.